Hi everyone and welcome back. So in the previous video we tried to install the Create React app and this is how it looked like once the process is complete. You can see the package.json. Here we have three major packages: React, React DOM and React Scripts, and how to run this project using npm run start. You can build the code using npm run build, npm run test and eject, right? This is a particular command which will help you to expose the configurations. You do it only when there is a need, okay? What it is doing is, it is exposing all the internal configurations of the Create React app, and this is a one-way process. Okay, so till now we were using Webpack, Babel, all the other dependencies to run the project, right? Internally, Create React app is also using that, but that is not being exposed. So when you do the eject, it will expose all the configurations for different environment, the Webpack configurations for all different environment. And then you will not be able to convert it back to the Create React app because you are going to get a lot of other configurations populated in the code. So if you want to keep it clean, you are fine with the Create React app, then don't do eject. Okay. Then we have npm run start, build and test. So we can just simply run these commands and we'll see what happens. We can just do npm install is already there. So npm run start. What it should do is it should actually be able to run our project. So npm run start will actually run the project. And what component do we have? Let's see. So on the name of component, we just have basic things in the app.js. We have some kind of a JSX return and it is just representing some logo. Okay. Here we can just remove all the other stuff. And we have index.js. That is the main file. Okay, what we are doing here is we are importing our component, app component, and we are rendering that component on the DOM node. And what is that DOM node? In the root node, right? If you go to publish and index.html, root should be some ID here. You can see ID, and here we are rendering our component. Okay, so what output we are getting is we are just getting simple output, and what it looked like is, okay, just give me a second. This is how we are able to see this. This is the React component we just got after running this application. And you can see what all things we have is, you can install the React dev tool and you can inspect the component. We have only app component here. You see, only single component. Coming back to our code. So this is our app.js. We are just having learn React, simple. Inside the header, this is what it is rendering, nothing else. This is the only component we have. And in the index.html, we have provided the ID where you wanted to render the component, because in index.js, you can see we are importing the component. So we have written component somewhere else. We are importing that component here. And then we are rendering that component using React DOM.render. Right? React DOM. Forget about this for now. React DOM.render, here we are getting the component and here we are rendering it in the root. That's it, right? We are also importing the CSS from CSS file index.css. So you can have your CSS created here. There are many ways to apply the styles on React component. Either you write inline style, you write CSS, you write CSS files, or we use some post CSS external module to do that. Here we are just setting the font files and all these things. Here you can see margin padding is 0, height width of body is 100%. Basic CSS you can write and save it, that's it. And that will be applied because Create React app is also keep compiling your code. In app.js we are not using logo, so we can remove it. Now this warning will be gone and you can see our application is running on these ports, like localhost 3000, or if you wanted to access it on the network, then you can use this IP from another system in the same network. Okay. Now, if you just look at the folder structure, we don't have anything, right? We just have an app, index.js, and setup test and basic things. Now, what we can do is we can start building our project. What we will have in the SRC, we will create more folders, whatever the components we need. Okay. We'll start with the basic component which we created in the previous video, how we can write it, and we will try to write both type of components. Here you can see it is a functional component. Till now we were just talking about classes. We were just talking about something like this: class hello, extends react.component, and we were writing the render functions inside it. This is what we were writing till now, but you can see that the difference now is here we are writing also the functions. So how these class-based components are different from the functional component. Okay, so I will be just moving away from the code for few videos where we will just talk about the state, props, how the components communicate with one another. I mean, if you wanted to create a simple component as a child component, you can create it. Just create a, like you can say, the child.js. Here you import all required things. What I need is, I need React. Sorry, it should be, I'm importing React from, this is the package name. Okay, and then I can just do export default hello. Let's see. Okay, this is the component I have. Simply I'm returning a child component. Now you can import it in the app.js here. So we have child component, so you can pass it. And child component we can render here instead of learn React. In the child comp, so now it is giving warning, right? Because anchor tag is breaking it. So in the child component itself, we can say right. So this is how we are actually rendering the component data. Can see the output somewhere, right? I'm child and learning React. Okay, this is a child component. Similarly, you can keep building the component tree and you can write parent, child, grandchild. Now the things which we need to understand here is how the data is being passed. I mean, the strict mode we'll understand later. For now I'm removing it. Okay, here if I wanted to pass some data, so we already talked about this, like I'm passing some array of, consider just a names, array of string. How can I pass it? Using like data, simple data, right? App component is accepting data. So how can I access this data in the props? This dot props dot data. So if you wanted to access it, then in the render function, this is the functional component, right? You are already going to access the props here, and how I can access? I will just accessing props something like this, and here you can do console.log props.data, or you can pass this data to the child component, and then further child component can access it, and it can pass this further. Okay, so this is how data communication will be happening. From the index.js we pass some data, child component will receive in the props. There is also something like state. Okay, like in child component I wanted to have state, so I will be writing constructor. There are many ways to write the initialize the state for a component. For now we will use this constructor only, then we will just see what all the other ways. So to avoid any confusion, what I will do is I will also convert this to a class-based component. So it will be helpful to understand things for the initial level. So here I will have to write render function, because class-based component must have a render function. And this return code block I will put in the render. Rest all things will be okay. Right, now you can also have state. So this is what I was talking about. in component there will be something which keeps changing, and based on that change you have to refresh your component. Okay, so now whenever this state is getting changed, so I have a names in the states which is can be changed. Whenever that is getting changed, I will be calling this render function automatically. React will be calling it. Okay, so this is important. So on UI with the user interactions, things keeps changing, right? And you see the refreshed UI, the new data coming, or like shopping cart, you click adding and removing, the cart getting impacted, right? How that is happening? That is happening with the help of re-rendering. So we have talked about React are declarative UIs, means there is some internal state which keep refreshing the component with the newest data. Okay, so we have received this props.data which I can access now using this, not using props.data, and I can pass it using this.props.data. We'll use these all different ES6 syntax to extract the using destructuring and all. We are just using like class-based component for now, just class and import export, but we can also use these destructuring principles. Like if you wanted to get data, const data equal to this.props, here you can apply destructuring. Okay, it should be const, and we are passing this data instead of putting this much lines of code, right? So this is a class-based component. We have the state, we have the props, we are passing the props to the child component. Child component is also class-based, so it will be able to access it using this.props.data. You can change this. I mean, if you are confused with this data word, okay, I got names, I'm passing that in the data, so I will be accessing using this.props.data. This.props.data, here I can call it as names. So in child component, I will be accessing it using this.props.names. Okay, here you can run a loop, whatever you want. So const name list equal to this.props.names.map I can do, and I can return a just render every child component, because names may be duplicates, so I need to have a unique key which I talked about. So you can use index here if you're not getting anything which is unique, and what we are returning is just h1 and the name. So you need to pass a key will be your index, and whatever the dynamic data we see, we have to wrap it inside a single curly braces. Okay, and now we got the name list, and you already know that React is able to render the array of JSX name list, right? So this is how it is working. We haven't talked about the state, we just talked about how we are passing the names from this index.js to app.js to child.js, right? How the data is being passed. Okay, in the next video, now we will come to the fundamentals, where we need to understand what is state, what is props, what is the importance. Props we are able to pass from parent to child to grandchild. What about the state? What is the objective of the state? State will hold the data in the component. This is mutable, which will keep change, and whenever the state is getting changed from the user interactions, it will call this render function. Either you talk about the functional component or the class-based component. Okay, that we will try to understand props and state in depth in coming 2 to 3 videos. We'll talk theoretically on the slides.